is your lover coming today? Mm. What time?
3.
Will you be going out or staying in?
Oh, I think we'll stay in.
I thought you wanted to go and see that exhibition.
I did, yes. But I think I'd prefer to stay in with him today.
Well, I must be off. Will he be staying long, do you think?
Mm.
About 6, then?
Yes.
Well, have a pleasant afternoon.
Mm.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Oh, just a little.
Bad traffic?
No, quite good traffic, actually.
Oh, good.
Oh, very smooth.
It seemed to me you were just a little late.
Am I?
Just a little.
It was a bit of a jam on the bridge. A pleasant day.
Mmm. I was in the village this morning.
Oh, yes. See anyone?
Not really, no. I had lunch.
In the village?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, good.
Quite fair.
And what about this afternoon? Pleasant afternoon.
Quite marvellous.
Your lover came, did he?
Mm, oh, yes.
Did you show him the hollyhocks?
The hollyhocks?
Yes.
No, I didn't.
Oh.
Should I have done?
No, no, it's just I seem to remember you saying he was interested in gardening.
Mm. Yes, he is. Interested, actually.
Oh. Did you go out at all, or did you stay in?
We stayed in.
And that blind hasn't been put up properly?
Yes, it is a bit crooked, isn't it?
Very sunny on the road. Of course, by the time I got onto it, it was beginning to sink, but I'd imagine it was quite warm here this afternoon. It was warm in the city.
Was it?
Mm, pretty stifling. I'd imagine it was quite warm everywhere.
Quite a high temperature, I believe.
Oh, did it say so on the wires?
I think it did, yes.
One more before dinner.
Hmm.
I see you had the Venetian blinds down.
We did, yes.
The light was terribly strong.
It was. Awfully strong.
The trouble with this room is it catches the light so directly when it's shining. You didn't move to another room. It must have been blinding.
It was. That's why we put the blinds down.
Well, the thing is, it gets awfully hot in here with the blinds down.
Would you say so?
Perhaps not. Perhaps it just feels hotter.
Yes. That's probably it. What did you do this afternoon?
It was a long meeting. Rather inconclusive.
It's a cold supper. Do you mind?
Not in the least.
I didn't seem to have time to cook anything today.
Oh, by the way, I rather wanted to ask you something.
What?
Well, does it ever occur to you that while you're spending your afternoons being unfaithful to me, I'm sitting in my office going through balance sheets and graphs?
What a funny question.
No, I'm curious.
You've never asked me that before?
I've always wanted to know.
Well, of course it occurs to me.
Oh, it does? And what's your attitude to that, then?
It makes it all the more piquant.
Does it really? You mean while you're with him, you actually have a picture of me sitting in my office going through balance sheets?
Only at certain times.
Of course.
Not all the time.
Oh, well, naturally.
At particular moments.
But indeed, I'm not completely forgotten.
Oh, by any means.
It's rather touching, I must admit.
How could I forget you?
Oh, quite easily, I should think.
But I'm in your house.
With another.
But it's you I love.
I beg your pardon?
But it's you I love.
Let's have another drink, shall we? What shoes are they? Those shoes, rather high-heeled, unfamiliar.
Is that sorry?
Sorry, I beg your pardon.
I'll take them off.
Quite the most comfortable shoes to be wearing for an evening at home. I would have thought. So you had a picture of me, did you? This afternoon. My office.
I did, yes. It wasn't a terribly convincing one, though.
No, why not?
Because I knew you weren't there. I knew you were with your mistress.
Was I?
Aren't you hungry?
I had a heavy lunch.
How heavy?
Oh, what a beautiful sunset.
Weren't you?
What mistress?
Richard.
No, it's simply the word that's so odd.
Is it? Why? I'm honest with you, aren't I? Why can't you be honest with me?
Because I haven't got a mistress. I'm very well acquainted with a whore, but I haven't got a mistress. There's a world of difference.
A whore?
Yes, just a common old garden slut, that's all. Not worth talking about, handy between trains. Not anymore.
You don't travel by train, you travel by car.
Quite. Quick cup of cocoa while they check the oil and water.
Sounds at least they arrive.
No.
I must say, I never expected you to admit it so readily.
No, why not? You've never put it to me so bluntly before, have you? Frankness at all costs, essential to a healthy marriage, don't you agree?
Of course.
You agree?
Entirely.
I mean, you're utterly frank with me, aren't you?
Utterly.
About your lover. I must follow your example.
Thank you. Yes, I've suspected it for some time.
Have you really? Perceptive.
But I must say, I can't believe she's just... What do you say?
Why not?
It's just not possible. You have such taste. You care so much for grace and elegance in women.
And wit, yes.
Wit,
yes. Terribly important wit. For a man.
Is she witty?
Oh, these terms just don't apply. You can't sensibly inquire whether a whore is witty or not. It's of no significance whether she is or she isn't. She's simply a whore. A functionary. She either pleases or displeases.
And she pleases you.
Well, today she pleases. Tomorrow, one can't say.
I must say, I find your attitude to women rather alarming.
Oh, why? I wasn't looking for your double, was I? I wasn't looking for a woman I could love as you, whom I could respect and admire as I do you, was I? No. All I wanted was, well, how shall I put it? Someone who could express and engender lust with all lust's cunning. Nothing more.
Dignity.
The dignity is in my marriage.
Or sensibility.
Sensibility likewise. I wasn't looking for such a tribute.
First.
You.
I don't think that's true.
Well, who then? We play it for articulation whenever desired.
You can't pretend a picture gives me great pleasure.
Well, it wasn't intended to. Pleasure is mine.
Yes,
well, surely your own afternoon pleasures are sufficient, aren't they? You don't expect extra pleasure from my pastimes, do you?
Not at all.
Well, then why all these questions?
Well, it was you who started it. Asking me so many questions about my side of it. You don't normally do that.
Object of curiosity, that's all. You're not suggesting I'm jealous, surely?
Darling, I know you'd never stoop to that.
Oh, good God, no. And what about you? You're not jealous, are you?
No. From what you tell me about your lady, I seem to have a far richer time than you do.
Possibly. What piece? Come and look. What would happen if I came home early one day? I wonder.
What would happen if I followed you one day, I wonder?
Oh, perhaps we'd all meet for tea in the village.
Why the village? Why not here?
Here? What an extraordinary remark. Your poor love has never seen the night from this window, has he?
No. He's obliged to leave before sunset, unfortunately.
Doesn't he get a bit tired with these damn afternoons? This eternal tea time? I would. To have as a constant reminder of your lust, a milk jug and teapot must be terribly dampening.
He's very adaptable.
Yes.
And of course, when one puts the blinds down, it does become a kind of evening.
Yes, I suppose it would. What does he think of your husband?
He respects you.
I'm rather moved by that remark, in a strange kind of way. I think I understand why you like him so much.
He's terribly sweet. Has his moods, of course.
Yeah, who doesn't?
But I must say, he's very loving. His whole body emanates love.
Oh, how nauseating.
No.
Manly-witted, I hope.
Entirely.
Sounds tedious.
Not at all. He has a wonderful sense of humour.
Oh, jolly good. He makes you giggle, does he? We'll make sure the neighbours don't hear. The last thing we need is gossip.
It's wonderful to live out here. So far away from the main road. So secluded.
Yes, I do agree. Well, this isn't much good. He's married, isn't he? Happily.
And you're happy, aren't you? You're not in any way jealous?
No.
Good. Because I think things are beautifully balanced, Richard.
Not till Friday. Bye-bye.
Richard, you won't be home too early today, will you?
Do you mean he's coming again today? Good gracious, he was here yesterday. Coming again today?
Yes.
Oh, well, no. I shall go to the National Gallery.
Right.
Well, bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you. anything?
No, thank you.
Why not?
I have some. Do I owe you anything?
Mrs. Owen just had 3 jars.
Clotted. What do I owe you?
Oh, it's not Saturday.
Thank you.
Don't you fancy any cream?
Thank you.
Mrs. Owen had 3 jars.
Where's your light? Is it here? Is it here? Is it here?
No! What do you think you're doing?
I'm dying for a coffee.
I'm waiting for my husband.
Just give me a light, to be honest. Are you all right, miss? I got rid of that gentleman. Did he hurt you in any way?
How wonderful of you. No, no, I'm all right. Thank you.
Well, it was very lucky I happened to be passing. You wouldn't believe what could happen in such a beautiful park.
No, you wouldn't.
Well, still, you've come to no harm.
I can never thank you enough. I'm terribly grateful. I really am.
Well, maybe you should sit down for a second and calm yourself.
Oh, I'm quite calm. But yes, thank you. Where shall we sit?
Well, we can't sit out. It's raining. What about that park keeper's hut?
Do you think we should? I mean, what about the park keeper?
I am the park keeper.
I never imagined I could meet anyone so kind.
To treat a lovely young lady like you like that's unpardonable.
You seem so mature, so appreciative.
Well, of course.
So gentle. So perhaps it was all for the best.
I don't know what you mean.
So that we could meet. So that we could meet. You and I.
I'm sorry, I don't quite follow you.
Don't you?
I'm sorry, I'm waiting for my wife. She'll be 30 minutes.
You mustn't worry.
No, really, she'd be here any minute.
Can't you speak to strange girl?
No.
Oh, how sickening you are, how terrible.
I'm sorry.
You men all alike. Give me a cigarette.
I bloody well won't.
I beg your pardon.
Come here, Dolores.
Oh, no, don't
you want to get crushed? You can't get in. The hut's locked. We're alone. You're trapped.
Trapped? I'm a married woman. You can't treat me like this.
Ooh. Come here, Dolores. It's tea time, Mary.
Where's your husband?
My husband, you know where he is.
Where?
He's at work.
Poor fella. Working away all day. I wonder what he's like.
Oh, Max.
I wonder if we'd get on, him and me. I wonder if we'd, like, you know, hit it off.
I shouldn't think so.
Why not?
We've got very little in common.
Do we? I mean, he's certainly very accommodating, isn't he? He knows all about your afternoons, doesn't he?
Of course.
He's known for years. Why does he put up with it?
Why are you suddenly talking about him? I mean, what's the point of it?
Why does he put up with it?
Shut up!
I asked you a question.
He doesn't mind.
Doesn't he? Well, I'm beginning to mind.
What did you say?
I'm beginning to mind. It's got to stop.
Are you serious?
It's got to stop.
You're joking?
No, I'm not.
Why? Because of my husband? Not because of my husband, I hope. That's going a little far, I think.
No, no, it's nothing to do with your husband. It's because of my wife.
Your wife?
I've been deceiving her for years. Can't deceive her any longer. It's killing me. Don't touch me.
What did you say?
You heard.
But your wife knows, doesn't she? You've told her all about us.
No.
She's known all the time.
She doesn't know. She thinks I know a whore. That's all some spare time whore. That's what she thinks.
Yes, but be sensible, my love. She doesn't mind, does she?
She'd mind if she knew the truth, wouldn't she?
Truth. What are you talking about?
She'd mind if she knew. In fact, I've got a full-time mistress. 2 or 3 times a week. A woman of wit, grace, imagination,
yes,
intelligence.
Yes, you have.
Yeah, and an affair that's been going on for years.
She doesn't mind. She wouldn't mind. She's happy. She's happy. I wish you'd stop this rubbish anyway. Doing your best to ruin the whole afternoon. Darling, you don't really think you could have what we have with your wife, do you? I mean, my husband, for instance, completely appreciates that I need to.
How does he bear it? Your husband, how does he bear it? Doesn't he smell me when he comes home in the evening? What does he say? God, he must be mad. What time is it? 4:30. Now, when he's in his office and he knows what's going on, how does he bear it?
Max.
How?
He's happy for me. He appreciates the way I am. He understands.
Well, perhaps I should meet him. You know, have a word.
Are you drunk?
Yeah, perhaps I should do that. After all, he's a man like me. We're both men. You're just a bloody woman.
Stop it! What's the matter with you? What's happened to you? Please, please stop it. What are you doing? Playing a game?
A game? I don't play games.
Oh, you do, you do. You surely are like them.
Well, I played my last game.
Why?
The children.
What?
I've got to think of the children.
What children?
Oh, my children, my wife's children. Any minute now, they'll be coming out of boarding school. I've got to think of them.
I want to whisper something to you. Please. Can I? Please, darling. It's whispering time, isn't it? Earlier it was tea time, wasn't it? Wasn't it? Now it's whispering time. You like me to whisper to you. You like me to love you. Whispering. Listen, you mustn't worry about wives, husbands, things like that. It's silly. It's really silly. It's you. You now. Here. Here with me. Here together. That's what it is, isn't it? You take tea with me. You whisper to me. You do that, don't you? That's what it is. That's us. Love me.
You're too bony. That's what it is. I could put up with everything if it wasn't for that. You're too bony.
Me? Bony? Don't be ridiculous.
I'm not.
How can you say I'm bony?
Every move I make, your bones stick into me. I'm sick of dirty bones.
But I'm fat. Look at me. I'm plump anyway. You always told me I was plump.
Well, you were plump once. You're not plump anymore.
Look at me.
Well, you're not plump enough. You're nowhere near plump enough. You know what I like? I like enormous women. Like great big feminine uttered bullocks.
You mean cows?
I don't. I mean great big voluminous feminine bullocks with udders. Once, years ago, you vaguely resembled one. But now, compared to my ideal, you're just skin and bone.
You're having a lovely joke.
It's no joke.
What a difference a day made. 24 little hours. What the sun and the flowers. Since you said you were mine, Lord, what a difference a day makes. There's mine. difference a day makes. There's a rainbow before me. Skies above can't be stormy. Since that moment of bliss, that thrilling kiss, it's heaven when you find romance on your menu. What a difference a day made. Is you.
Hello.
Hello.
Watching the sunset. Drink?
Not at the moment, thank you.
Oh, what a dreary conference. Went on all day. Terribly fatiguing. Still good work done, I think. Something achieved. Sorry I'm rather late. Had to have a drink with one or two of the overseas people. Good chaps. How are you?
Fine.
Good. You seem a little depressed. Anything the matter?
No.
What sort of a day have you had?
Not bad.
Not good?
Fair.
I am sorry. It is good to be home. You can't imagine what a comfort it is. Your lover come? Sarah?
What? Sorry, I was thinking of something.
Did your lover come?
Oh, yes, he came.
In good shape?
I have a headache, actually.
Wasn't he in good shape?
We all have our off days.
He too? I thought the whole point of being a lover is one didn't. I mean, if I were called upon to fulfill the duties of a lover, for instance, and felt disposed to accept a job, I would just as soon give it up as to be found incapable of executing its proper and consistent obligations.
You do use long words.
Would you prefer I use short ones?
No, thank you.
Well, I am sorry you've had a bad day.
It's quite all right.
Perhaps things will improve.
Perhaps. I hope so.
Nevertheless, I think you are very beautiful.
Thank you.
Yes, I find you very beautiful. I have great pleasure in being seen with you. When we're out to dinner, or at the theater.
I'm so glad.
Or the Hunt Ball.
Oh, yes, the Hunt Ball.
Yes. Great pride. To see you walk as my wife on my arm. To hear you laugh. To see you smile, walk, talk, bend, be still. To hear your command of contemporary phraseology, your delicate use of the latest idiomatic expression so subtly employed. Yes. And to feel the envy of others, and their attempts to gain favor with you by fair means or foul. And your austere grace confounding them, and to know that you are my wife. It's a source of profound satisfaction to me. What's for dinner?
I haven't thought.
Why not?
I find the thought of dinner fatiguing. I prefer not to think about it.
It's rather unfortunate, because I'm hungry. Well, you hardly expect me to embark on dinner, do you, after a day spent sifting through matters of high finance in the city? Or one could almost say you're falling down on your wifely duties.
Oh, dear.
Well, I rather expected this may happen sooner or later.
How's your whore?
Splendid.
Fatter or thinner?
I beg your pardon?
Is she fatter or thinner?
She gets thinner every day.
That must displease you.
Not at all. I'm very fond of thin ladies.
I thought the contrary.
Really? And why would you have thought that? Of course, your failure to have dinner on the table is quite consistent with the life you've been leading for some time now, isn't it?
Is it?
Perhaps I'm being unkind. Am I being unkind?
I don't know.
Well, yes, I am. You see, in the traffic jam on the bridge just now, I came to a decision.
Oh, what?
Well, it has to stop.
What?
Your debauchery. Your life of depravity. Your part of illegitimate lust. I'm no longer disposed to put up with it.
Would you like some cold ham?
Do you understand?
Not at all. I have something cold in the fridge for you.
Too cold, I'm sure. The fact is, this is my house. And from today, I forbid you to entertain your lover on these premises. It applies to any time of the day. Is that understood?
I've made a salad for you.
Are you drinking?
Yes, I'll have one.
What are you drinking?
You know, when I drink, we've been married 10 years.
Yes, so we have. It's strange, you know, it's taken me so long to appreciate, this humiliate, and ignominy of my position.
Did you take my lover 10 years ago? Not quite. Not on the honeymoon.
That's irrelevant. The fact is, I am a husband who's extended to his wife's lover an open invitation for any afternoon of her desire. I've been too kind. Haven't I been too kind?
Well, of course you're terribly kind.
Well, perhaps you will give him my compliments by letter, if you like, and ask him to cease his visits from the 12th.
How can you talk like this? Why today? So suddenly, You've had a hard day at the office? All these overseas people, so tiring. But it's silly. It's so silly to talk like this. I'm here for you. And you've always appreciated how much these afternoons mean. You've always understood. Understanding is so rare, so dear.
Do you think it's pleasant to know your wife is unfaithful to you 2 or 3 times a week with great regularity?
Richard.
It's insupportable. It's become insupportable. I'm no longer disposed to put up with it.
Sweet Richard, please.
Please what? Shall I tell you what I suggest you do?
What?
Take him out to the fields. Find a slag heap, a rubbish dump. What about that? Buy a canoe, find a stagnant pond,
Anything anywhere, but not in my living room.
I'm afraid that's not possible.
Then why not?
I said it's not possible.
But if you want your lover so much, surely it's the obvious thing to do. After all, his entry to this house is now barred. I'm trying to be helpful, my dear, because of my love for you. You can see that, can't you? If I find him on these premises again, I'll kick his teeth in.
You're mad.
I'll kick his head in.
How about your own bloody whore?
I paid her off.
Have you? Why?
She was too bony.
But you liked. You said you liked Richard. But you loved me.
Of course.
Don't you? I mean, you know better than I do, darling. All is well. All is well. The evenings and the afternoons. Listen, I do have dinner for you. I wasn't serious. It's beef bourguignon, and tomorrow I'll have chicken chasseur. Would you like it?
Adulteress.
You can't talk like this. It's impossible. You know you can't. You're doing?
What's this? What is it? What is it?
You shouldn't touch that.
But it's in my house. It either belongs to me, or to you, or to another.
It's nothing. I bought it in a jumbo sale. It's nothing. What do you think it is? Put
this.
It back.
Nothing. A drum in my cupboard.
Put it back.
It isn't by any chance something to do with your illicit afternoons, is it?
Not at all. Why should it?
This is used, isn't it? I can guess.
You guess nothing. Give it to me.
How does he use it? How do you use it? Do you use it together? It's not just an ornament, I take it. What function does this fulfill?
You've no right to question me. No right at all. It was our arrangement. No questions of this kind. Please, please don't. It was our arrangement.
But I want to know.
Don't.
Do you play it? Do you play it together?
You stupid! Do you think he's the only one who comes? Do you? Do you think he's the only one I entertain? Don't be silly. I have other visitors. Other visitors all the time. I receive all the time. Other afternoons. All the time. When neither of you know. Neither of you. I give them strawberries in season. With cream. Strangers. Total strangers. But not to me. Not why they're here. They come to see the hollyhocks. And then they stay for tea. Always. Always.
Is that so?
What are you doing?
Is that what you do? Like that? What fun. Got a light? Got a light? Come on, don't be a spoiled sport. Jasmine won't mind if you give me a light. You look a little pale. Why are you so pale, lovely girl like you?
Don't say that.
I've locked up. You're alone. No one knows you're here. You're trapped.
You mustn't do this. You mustn't do it.
Come on, give us a light. Come on, give us a light. You're trapped.
I can't get out! I'm trapped! You've no right! my husband will understand. My husband does understand. Come here. Come down here. I'll explain. After all, think of my marriage. He adores me. Come here and I'll whisper to you. I'll whisper to you. It's whispering time, isn't it? Very late tea, isn't it? But I think I'll like it. Aren't you sweet? I've never seen you before after sunset. My husband's at a late night conference. Yes, you look different. Why are you wearing this strange suit and this tie? You should wear something else, don't you? Take off your jacket. Would you like me to change? Would you like me to change my clothes? I'll change for you, darling. Shall I? Would you like that?
Yes. Change. Change. Change your clothes. You lovely whore.
That means baby mama. Believe me, this chick's no sense. But I